Hi, we're here today at Google I.O. to talk to Jay. And Jay, do you mind introducing yourself and talking a little bit about your company?
No problem. I'm Jay Hinman. I'm the Senior Director of Partner and Product Marketing at MobiTV. And MobiTV, we're relatively new to Android development, and we're kind of showcasing some of our applications at the show right now. Our core product is MobiTV, and that's 40 live or made for mobile channels from big brands like ESPN, ABC, CBS, NBC, Discovery, etc. And that's been available for a long time on different platforms and is now being ported over to Android, which we're really excited about. Mobi for Biz is another new product that we've come out with that allows you to get personalized breaking video alerts on stocks that you happen to be to own in your portfolio, as well as watch live business TV on CNBC, Bloomberg, and others.
Okay, that's great.
Thanks.
So you mentioned being kind of new to Android. What is it about Android that got you to port your application to it and make it available?
It's two things. First of all, just our development team was very excited when Android was announced. The fact that they knew it was going to be very open source and that they'd have the ability to kind of get into the code and do a lot of things that they maybe aren't able to do on other platforms. But also, we generally let our carrier's handset roadmap kind of dictate which handsets we port to, and we're very close with AT&T, Sprint, and others. Knowing that they've got Android devices on the horizon meant that we were going to be developing our preloaded applications on those anyway.
Okay, great. Yeah. One thing developers really like to hear is war stories from the trenches. Do you have anything you could share with us?
Yeah. I talked to our development team a little bit about this. So we have a product called MobiVJ that we're also making available for Android. And MobiVJ is roughly 18 channels of music videos, but also a whole bunch of audio-only channels, so radio channels from different genres of music. And one of the things they noticed as they started developing this product is that the way the Android widget for video playback works is that when you try to play an audio-only clip, it's actually looking for video. So in a hybrid product like this that's both audio and video, it's looking for video to display on the screen. If it doesn't, it won't even play the audio feed. So what they did is they embedded a single pixel and then painted over it, a single video pixel. So when you start that audio stream, it pulls up the video pixel. It says, oh, yep, it's definitely video is playing. And then it goes ahead and plays the audio stream. And if it happens to be video that's playing, it just goes full screen and plays the whole video clip.
Okay, that's great.
Yeah.
Are there other things about the tool chain or the development process that make it interesting to develop on Android, or particularly interesting?
One of the things that our team really likes is the monkey tool, that it allows them to kind of do some emulation. And it's really pseudo-random events that are generated by the tool that allows them to go ahead and use it the way a user is using it. The way a user will kind of fumble with it and poke buttons and push things here and there, that's what the monkey tool does. So that it has system-level events like that and then user-generated events. And it does a random stream of that, and then it'll do one that's a little bit different that's a random stream, and it shows you how users would really interact with it. And it's really helpful in the development cycle.
That's great. Are there particular things about the Android platform, because it's open, that you can do with your application that you might not be able to do on other platforms?
Yeah, there's a couple things. The virtual keypad or keyboard that allows you to kind of touch the search box in our applications and then just boom, it just kind of pops right up there is really new to us, and it enables some functionality that we're just kind of now thinking through how we're going to take advantage of it. And also the painting over video, the fact that that keyboard will pop up even when a video is playing in the background allows us to do some kind of text-based stuff that is really cool. So you can still type over that video while it's playing, the keyboard goes back down and the video continues to play. And so it makes the application more rich and allows us to do things we couldn't otherwise do.
Well, that's great. Well, thank you for taking the time to talk to us today. I look forward to exploring your application.
My pleasure.
All right.
Thank you.
Great. Thanks.
All right.